Hi, friends. Welcome back to Two Blondes Drink Beer. I'm Kara and this is Candy.
Hi.
Today we're going to be drinking a BJCP Category 34C, which is an experimental beer. Today we're drinking Sour Me Unicorn Farts by Dewclaw Brewing.
Yay!
Yay!
It's a party up in here today.
And we've got glitter because there's glitter in this beer.
It is literally called a glittered sour ale. I am so excited about this. It has edible glitter in it.
This is going to be a fun one. Let's talk about the can.
Let's talk about it.
It has a unicorn, of course.
It has a rainbow coming out of the butt.
Yeah.
It's a unicorn fart.
It looks hilarious.
It's really funny. And that unicorn looks super happy, FYI.
Of course it is.
Yeah. This is a hilarious can. I really like the swirly, like, lavender and blue background. And then that picture of that unicorn's hilarious.
Yeah.
I'm enjoying it.
You can't not smile when you look at this can.
So true.
Of course we have to drink this one.
Yeah. Okay. So let's move on to aroma. That's hilarious. I really hope I can see the glitter.
Oh my gosh, that would be amazing.
Not so far.
Where is Dewclaw Brewing?
It's in Baltimore, Maryland. I don't see glitter in here.
I really wanted to.
It's pretty, but I don't see it. All right, let's smell it. Okay. Aroma out of 12.
It smells sour.
It does smell sour. It says it's a sour ale with fruity cereal. I don't know if it's like Fruity Pebbles or what. Do you know?
It is. Do you know what this is? This is a collaboration between Dewclaw Brewing and Diablo Donuts in Baltimore.
Get out of town.
Because they had a donut that has Fruity Pebbles on top of it.
Yeah, they do.
So if you notice on the can, also has over here on the side a donut plus beer.
Yes. That's really funny.
So it has fruit and cereal.
Fruity cereal.
And glitter.
And edible glitter.
In the beer.
Based on the flavor profile of the famous Unicorn Farts donut made with fruity cereal. That's hilarious. I don't really smell much fruity. I smell a lot of sour.
Maybe I should have read this earlier. So sparkles may settle, swirl, or gently invert before pouring, which I did not do.
We'll drink it down, and we'll try again. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Dewclaw. We didn't do that right.
I didn't read the instructions.
But we'll do better the next time.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so yeah, I just get sour. Do you get
sour, a little fruit.
It smells good. I mean,
yeah.
I would give it a 12 out of
12. 12 out of 12 for
smells
aroma.
Like a delicious, sour ale.
Appearance. It had a pretty good head when I first poured it.
It does. It's kind of pretty. I think it's a really pretty yellow color.
Yeah.
It's a little bit deeper than a light color. Mm-hmm. It's opaque.
Yes.
It's nice. It doesn't have much of a head, but I'm cool with it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Seems super bubbly still.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Three out of three. And then we'll see if there's more glitter later.
I'm excited
for that. Plus
all right, let's taste it, drink it down so we can get more glitter out of the can.
Or more sparkles.
That's super sour.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, I'm going to pucker up. It's tart.
It is, but there's something else. What's the something else?
I don't know, but I may or may not have brushed my teeth before I came over.
You know better than that. Spearmint goes well with no beer.
I'm not really sure why I did that.
Minty fresh breath for me, maybe.
For you, but
special.
It's really making this something for
myself.
I'm
trying hard to get the fruity cereal, and I don't really get it. I get some like strawberry though.
Yeah, cereal makes me think sweet, and I'm not getting any sweetness.
No, it's
at
very
all.
Sour.
Yes,
but I'm trying to get some Fruity Pebbles vibe, and I don't know. I get citrus from the sour, and maybe a little strawberry.
I'm trying to figure out which.
I do feel like there's something else in here besides just the straight up sour taste though, right?
Yes.
What is that?
I don't know. It's at the end. It's the way it
finishes.
It's almost like a...
If you guys hold on a minute while we just keep drinking this.
It'll come to me.
We'll get there. We'll get there. I'm just going to sit back drink for a minute.
I mean, I want to say almost like a lambic. Like it's...
That's a fruit beer. Yeah, it's a fruity sour. There is fruit. I mean, a fruit. But you're right. It's not sweet at all. So it's hard because sometimes you associate those fruity beers with sweetness, right? And this 100% is not.
No, and I can't quite pinpoint the fruit like I could with the rainbow sherbet that we had from Prairie Ales. You could definitely tell it was like the, the orange and the lime,
tropical citrus.
Yeah, you could pick those out.
I feel like there's strawberry here, not like sweet strawberry, but like, strawberries that you eat from the grocery store, like not that artificial strawberry taste.
Yeah.
Because it's not syrupy in any way.
That makes sense. Yeah, it does seem like strawberry. Strawberry's also
I don't
really
know if I like that, though.
Strawberry's hard to do in beer, too.
Yeah.
I feel like.
I like that.
Okay, I drank it down a bunch.
I know, I want to try. I really want to see some glitter. I'm so excited if I can actually see glitter.
Swirling gently,
and then invert before pouring. Well, hold up. I mean, does that help? Did you get some?
I still don't feel like I see any sparkles.
I tried hard. I so badly want to see glitter. Edible glitter? Sign me up.
I don't see any.
I don't either! It makes me so sad!
Kind of a letdown.
It's so pretty.
It's so
I give
pretty.
It like an 18 out of 20, I think.
On the taste.
Flavor. Are you good with that?
Yeah.
I feel like that's good. I kind of want to go back to appearance and give it like a 2 out of 3 they promised me glitter and I don't see any.
Yeah, agreed. I think I'm going to downgrade my...
Sorry, Duclaw. We were so excited for the edible glitter. I really wanted to see it.
And maybe it's just because we did it wrong, but...
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Yeah.
So, 2 out of 3 on appearance. 18 out of 20 on flavor.
Mouthfeel out of 5.
I think 4 out of 5.
I would give it a 5 out of 5.
Give it a 5 out of 5?
Yeah, I feel like it's super bubbly. It's very astringent because of that sour. I mean, it's going to suck all that moisture out of your mouth.
It's
got a really nice light body.
I mean, this beer is definitely on the higher end of a sour slider scale. Like,
it is.
It's very, very tart.
And so then overall, out of 10, what do you think?
I'm thinking 8 out of 10. What are you thinking? 7 out of 10?
I would do 8 out of 10.
Okay.
Now for me, that makes an even 5 off. So I don't know where you at, but I made my math easy.
I just had one more than you, I think, off. So
Duclaw Brewing.
Yes.
Is in Baltimore, Maryland.
Yes.
Started by Dave Benfield, who apparently went all through college, like falling in love with home brewing and loving beer and studying it and making his own beers. And he was supposed to be going into the family business of like electrical engineering or something. And he says one day his dad was like, "You're going to brew beer, right?" And he was like, "Oh, yeah, yeah, I am." And there we are.
That's
so,
a funny story.
Yeah. And their motto's funny too. It's on all the cans and on their website. It's craft be cherished, rules be damned.
Oh, I can get behind that.
I liked that. And all of their beer names I found hilarious, too. If you want to go, obviously you could go to the tap house. That'd be awesome. But just the website, too. And look at all their beer names. They're all awesome. Like, this isn't atypical for them to call something Sour Me Unicorn Fart. So that's a 45 out of 50 for me.
44 out of 50 for me.
For Duclaw Brewing Company's Sour Me Unicorn Farts. Cheers! Kind of gets them up for audits a little
bit.
Here,
let's see.
Yeah.
It's not a.
Woo! Our local unicorn expert in the background.
Ta-da!
She's very shy.